Let me show you what I'm talking about.
Factory fans, well, I've been a lazy bum and got into all kinds of crap we have to take care of because of our retirement. I know. I know. So, I was teased about that. Anyways, this is the paint table. Alright, how to tell when your paint is okay to keep for a while longer or to throw away. Now, most of you know this, but I'm going to show you a couple ways you could restore it, even if you think it's shot. Now, when it's a piece of concrete, yeah, there's no bringing it back, okay? But let's try a few of these. Good. Yeah, I didn't get anything on the model done, man. I'm so sorry. This is going to show how I'm trying to get the colors ready. It's worth a half an episode. Yeah. All right. So, what we're going to do, you can restore some paints, even if you think they're long gone. But, you know, obviously, against the sludge tarry point, is that's it. There's no winning. So, I haven't looked at these paints in several months. I have stirred them every 3-4 weeks. But it looks to me like most of these are dead. Man, this is definitely dead. I don't even have to test that. So, this is almost like a funny video. See when it's like that? And it's like got the consistency of rubber. Yeah, I even God can't help this paint. That's about it. Yeah, spongy, extraterrestrial looking thing. A Smurf run through a blender. I don't know. I mean, we should find one that's restorable here. Jeepers, mister. Whoa. What have we got here? And I do have a dipping pool over here with mineral spirits. Let's see here. No. Melted tank from the war? No. Okay. Papa finds no paint. Today's story. Alright. This is, I know what this is. This is an old prismatic mix. It's still good, actually. But I don't think it's restorable. The powder stuck to the bottom, so it's kind of gone through a stage of no longer being really the molecules it once was. All right, bye-bye. That's clean with alcohol. Different things. Mineral spirits for the paints and for the alclad or the, what's it called, Pearl-X. It's alcohol. Because basically the mix is like 90% alcohol. Unless I'm very much mistaken. Let's see. Same thing. Oh yeah, I used this on something recently. Alright. Now, come on, there's got to be one that's restorable. Jeepers. Another trick to open a stuck paint thing is use a heat gun towards the top section for just a little while. Not enough for it to explode. But even though that would be kind of fun. Okay. Oh, what do we got here? What have we got here? Oh, this one. Even though it's rather gunky, it's softened enough. Because I believe I already added a bit of mineral spirits in it. It's been stirred quite a bit. If you get a little stirring tool like this, and you get past whatever hard chunks are in there. If they keep bouncing around the blade, then it's not usable. But if you mash it all up like mashing potatoes, that's what the, man, that is for. This is still good for another couple months. Now, this isn't what you call valuable information, maybe, but do remember some of this paint is quite expensive. And we'll do one more to give you the idea. Oh, no, no, no. It's like another planet in there. You don't want to land there. Even though you can stir them, I don't know, and add a little mineral spirits for a few months, it depends. Here it's been very, very hot. In the wintertime, it would have lasted, you know, almost a whole year. Average lifespan, even on a shelf in the heat I'm in, for every paint I buy is about 2 years max. And then it turns to sludge. Here's a perfect example of sludge. This is 50-50. Oof. I don't know. This is the consistency, like thicker than cottage cheese. See that? Cottage cheese, approximately. So, now remember, this is only the bottom bottle of mineral spirits. This is just one of those surgical trays. Let's see. Okay. Now, here's a little bit. Trying to center here. I've got this whole thing looking back. You know, you remember Reverse World? And that's actually a little too much, so we're going to put that back in the tray. All right, and it floats on top of the paint, so you don't have to worry about it gunking it up till you mix it. Okay. Oh, spurt, spurt. It's a happy bowl of paint. Also known as the most boring episode ever, ever, I tell ya. Stevie, I told you. Okay, all right, stop, stop. All right, now this was nearly unsavable, but with a little further thinning, some that's been sitting around for 6 months or longer can be saved. But remember, if it's mud, it's a dud. Ain't happening. Don't waste your time. All right, this is savable. This is, no, no, no. And this, no. All right. All done. Bravo. I know you were bored, but hey, some of you might have enjoyed it. Bye. All right, so pretty much the main point of the film. We now have everything together, all together, and we're going to go over each section because it's the way to pad the film, because I've been lazy. and I'm forced to say that. There's a gun pointed at my head. Here's your paragraph express etch. This is all the stuff you get together if you really want to build this thing right. I mean, it's going to cost a little bit of money, a few $100, sometimes more. And you get what you need. And then along the process of using each of these parts, you get a guided route to building the thing. You got to do this before you can do that. It's like having three sets of instructions to do the same thing. But in the end, you have something really nice, you know. Depending what your skill level at, regardless, you'll have something far better than you would have by having all these extras. So, we got our brass etching. Then we have 10 of controls, circuit boards to do all the lighting with. I use these boards pretty much 100% of the time on everything I build, and they're fairly reliable. I really can't complain too much. Once in a while I'll blow one up, although I'll never admit it, but otherwise everything's really, really cool with these. The nice thing is most of them I've used, so I'm quite familiar with them. Blue dish parts that Steve Smith sent. I don't think I skipped this last time. Lately, I just forget everything. Shuttle bay, very nice. I may add a little feature in there or something, but super clean, really nicely done. He sent me these little extras, and he has already done them. So, and here's a, let's see, where's the camera on this damn thing? There's the bridge section, which is very nicely painted. If it's a decal, well done. Probably, but still, very well placed, everything. I was like saying, man, he's good. you are, Steve. You're a very good modeler. I may show you Dewey Louie that he did for me, must be almost 20 years ago, which is when me and him kind of got to know each other a little bit. There's your engine rotation lighting. And in this case, I believe it's blue, so that should be interesting. I've never done one that was like bluish. We got the speakers for the bass. As you know, the bass is another kit unto itself. Ribbon wiring, which is real cool. That saves a lot of room. All right, so that's all the 10 of control in Steve Smith's middle. Next, we have Lou Dalmasso from Aztec Dummy. A lot of people like using fancy this and fancy that, but really, when you want results and you don't want a lot of messing about, straightforward, I always use Aztec Dummy. I do, because I'm an absolute Aztec idiot. So this is actually a notch above me. I had to study. Let's see. Then again, Steve Smith, who I, this kid is 90% Steve Smith. Decal sheets, right? Slide off, not, you know, the printer stuff or whatever, which you can do in a pinch, but not a little Starship. Sorry, kids. Two of them, because... Yes, I mess up. I know, it's hard. Please. And the kit itself, obviously. Anything else I missed here? Well, of course, the instructions for everything, which I'll ignore it for a screw-up and have to do it again. Hence the two sets. There's the logic, man. There's the logic. Saucer, not huge, so I mean, you could... I could put about 10 of these on a DeBoers, you know. Yeah, I know. But, you know, smaller, a little less expensive if I decide to sell it, more affordable. And just as cool. Frankly, people who do the really small versions with as much detail as the big ones, man, it's like building a ship in a bottle. I respect that. I've done some, but it's not my preferred choice. You know, I like to work on big. You got room, you can add all kinds of stuff. And it's impressive. You know, that's what I want. I want impact. But not everybody's got a living room enough for impact, Mr. Schmankey. So, you young people with your fancy tape recorders and stuff. Should start a new character again, Grandpa Looney Tunes. Anyways, so now we'll move on with the rest of the film. Again, I had to pad a lot, so there's a tutorial about how to restore like dying paint. Or recognize that it is dead. It's almost a comedy bit, I swear. And then later on, you know that telescope that I got back from Steve that was originally given to me by Robert Kennedy. The lineage goes on and on. Modelers have been around for thousands and thousands of years. So, beats me, man. And then the professor, well, apparently, I don't know what's going on, but the telescope is missing. And he has a thing about optics, this guy, prisms and wild stuff. He's out there somewhere in a vortex, and we don't know what he's doing.
The real bloody Elmo. Well, he's got a gun. A Glock, I believe.
Very good taste. Swine bastard, he's out to get me.
Yes, I know this
is a terrible video, but I'm here to possibly bring some kind of value to it, you know. He's been so lazy. Well, I shouldn't say that, but yeah, he's damn lazy. He's just...
I won't speak any further. But
he's trying not to get into total retirement mode, you know? When the remote control for the TV kind of melds with your hand and you go to sleep with it and stuff. Yeah.
He knows. Well,
let me show you what I'm talking about.
All right, from my position, let's put the...
Targets locked.
Yeah. What the hell is that? He's packing heat.
Target locked.
You know what they represent on Sesame Street
and what this killer actually is about? It's two very different things.
All right.
Well, let's see what happens. Targeting. Okay. Step back, Mr. Remote Control. Yes.
Let's see what happens. 3, 2, 1. Oh my. Oh, okay.
Thank you.